Hello and welcome to Roving Report, a program that gives you an overview of the developments in India's Northeast region. I'm your host Lumpen Vashum, and the highlights of today's program are: Government announces a string of initiatives for development in the Northeast region. Union ministers visit Assam to review development work. President Pranab Mukherjee urged youth of Mizoram to contribute towards national development. Delhiites get glimpses of the rich culture of Northeast. And people in Assam celebrate Rongali Bihu festival with great enthusiasm. Development in the Northeast region is one of the key tasks for the central government. In a recently held 64th plenary meeting of the Northeast Council in New Delhi, the government announced a string of initiatives being undertaken for the development in the Northeast region, including a daily flight from Delhi to Nagaland. We have a report.
Governors and chief ministers of the northeastern states, along with senior officials from state governments, central ministries and other organizations, came together to discuss the progress of developmental work at the 64th plenary meeting of the Northeast Council in capital New Delhi. Minister of State, Independent Charge for the Development of Northeastern Region, Dr. Jitendra Singh, chaired the event in the presence of Union Minister of State for Home Affairs, Kiran Rijiju. Reports on activities of the Council and different projects and schemes undertaken by various ministries were presented during the two-day-long event. Addressing the inaugural session, the donor minister elaborated upon the various steps being initiated by the government to facilitate all-round growth in the northeastern states across sectors.
We have started a practice which is unique of its kind, I think, in the history of independent India. We have started what you can describe as a rotational camp secretariat of the Ministry of Donor, because I realized that one important thing that we needed to do was to make the presence of the Ministry of Donor and also the presence of the Government of India or Mainstream India visible in Northeast. So under this practice, we will have the officials of the Ministry of Donor stationed in one of these states by rotation every month.
The donor minister also launched a dedicated website for Northeast tourism at the event that will give out information about tourism products of the region. Stressing on the need for developing better connectivity with the region, Singh announced a daily direct flight from Delhi to Nagaland. He also revealed that the government is keen on enhancing infrastructure and giving boost to connectivity within the region as well.
We have started a direct daily air flight to Nagaland, to Dimapur, which didn't exist earlier. So it's Nagaland sounded like a very remote destination. So we will have a flight which will, of course, will be via Kolkata. You don't have to change the aircraft. It will fly from Delhi to Dimapur and then take the same route back to Delhi, and it will be on a daily basis. This is going to commence from the 15th of this month.
Development in the northeastern region is high on the priority list of the central government. A number of steps are being taken to facilitate progress in different fields and bring the region at par with the other parts of the country and improve the socio-economic standard of the people.
In order to speed up the process of development and ensure the proper implementation of various government-run schemes, the union ministers are visiting the Northeast region on a regular basis. A number of national-level events are also being organized in the region to create greater integration. We have a report.
Railway Minister Suresh Prabhu was in Guwahati to inaugurate the 60th National-Level Railway Week Award function being held in the state for the very first time. He emphasized on the special focus being given to develop railway infrastructure in the Northeast and the possible employment opportunities for the educated youth. Around 151 officers and staff from all zonal railways were presented awards for their outstanding performance during the event.
The railway has a very clear-cut laid-out policy that despite the fact that railway is a all-India organization, we have deliberately created regional railway recruitment board to ensure that the local people, to an extent possible, to an extent desirable, to an extent necessary, will also get a share in the employment that we create. So this is a policy, despite the fact that railway is an all-India organization. We are also trying to find out how we can provide even indirect employment. See, when we start construction of such a magnitude in northeastern region, which is unprecedented, which will also create huge job in construction, in transportation, in other areas of laying down tracks, etc. So this is a very good, great opportunity for many local people.
Power Minister Piyush Goyal was also in the city to attend the Conference of Power, Renewable Energy and Mines organized by the Ministries of Power, Coal and New and Renewable Energy, Government of India. The two-day conference, held for the first time outside Delhi, was attended by representatives from across the country. The Power Minister discussed the power scenario of the Northeast and highlighted the investments being made in the region.
We are also investing nearly 10,000 crores to expand the transmission line capacity and the sub-transmission system of the northeastern 8 states, which Project Prime Minister Modi has cleared and launched in Tripura, I think only 2 months ago. That project is being expeditiously taken up so that power can reach the remote parts of Northeast. In terms of expanding renewable energy and thermal, I already mentioned earlier that we are taking that up on fast-track basis. For hydro, we will seek the support of the people of the Northeast to support hydro projects. It is only then that we can expand the more hydro projects.
The union ministers have been visiting the northeastern states to review development work of their respective departments in accordance with the Prime Minister's directive to visit the region on a regular basis to ensure speedy implementation of the center's programs.
Let us now take a look at some of the events that made news in the Northeast recently.
The 5-day-long Raj Shri Bhagyachandra Drama Festival 2014 was recently held at Hangnam Shang NT Theatre, Changge Gi, under the theme of Culture for Civilization. 6 well-known theatre organizations staged plays during the festival organized by Theatre Mirror with sponsorship from the Ministry of Culture, Government of India. A day-long blood donation camp was recently organized by the students' body of Assam Agriculture University, Jorhat, in collaboration with Jorhat Medical College and Hospital. The main aim was to inculcate a spirit of unity and discipline among the students and spread awareness about blood donation. A large number of students came forward to donate blood for the cause of saving lives of the needy people. Under the theme of Peace Through Culture, the first Thangjing Subdivision Cultural Festival was held recently at Khosabung DCC headquarters in Churachandpur district. The event was organized by Khosabung Area Youth Development Forum to express appreciation for the Cabinet's decision last year to recognize Thangjing, which comprises 125 villages, as a full-fledged subdivision. One of the main highlights of the event was the colorful performances by cultural troupes from different communities. Awards were also presented to the winners of the Khosabung Sports Meet at the event. Budding dancers from Imphal got a chance to showcase their skills at the Knockdown Dance Battle held at the Thangmei Bandh Athletic Union's Badminton Hall under the theme Dances Clean, Say No to Drugs and Doping. The event was organized by the Beat Sane crew with an objective of exposing the hidden talent of the youth and encouraging them to stay away from drugs. Over 50 youngsters competed with each other and mesmerized the audience with their powerful moves. The b-boying show exhibited by the participants was a main attraction as the dancers displayed a combined talent of gymnastics and dance.
President Pranab Mukherjee attended the convocation function of the Mizoram University in Aizawl and urged the Mizo youth to play an important role in nation building. A report.
President Pranab Mukherjee was accorded a guard of honor by the security forces upon his arrival in Aizawl. The president was on a two-day visit to Mizoram to attend the 10th convocation ceremony of the Mizoram University. Over 700 students were handed away their degrees and 39 students from various disciplines were awarded gold medals by the president. While speaking at the event, he called upon the youth of the state to come together in the process of shaping up the future of the nation.
India today is a nation on the move. In every field of activity, be it industries, be it business, trade, education or culture, we are marching forward gloriously, led by the idea, enterprise, and energy of our predominantly young population. An emerging India offers enormous opportunities to the youth of this country, including those of Mizoram. I call upon you to join hands with the youth from the rest of the country in forging the future of our nation.
Mukherjee also assured the youth of the state that every possible step is being taken to ensure that the youth from the region do not face any discrimination in cities across India.
Some time back, the capital city of Delhi had witnessed certain tragic and ugly incidents of attacks on young people from the Northeast. Both the Union government and the Delhi administration have taken firm action by not only apprehending and punishing the accused, but also putting in place measures to ensure that such incidents do not recur. We must ensure that the pluralistic character of our nation and her thread of unity, which is the collective pride of all Indians, are not weakened by such totally unacceptable events.
While lauding the university for receiving A grade by the National Assessment and Accreditation Council last year, the president also stressed on the need for improving the quality of higher education and refining the academic sector to utilize the utmost potential of the youth.
India's Northeast region has a rich and vibrant culture, and efforts are high to raise awareness about the region, its culture and food. Recently, a festival to promote the songs and dances of the Northeast was held in capital New Delhi. Let's take a look.
Songs and Dances of the Northeast, a day-long event at Indira Gandhi Indoor Stadium in New Delhi, was inaugurated by President Pranab Mukherjee. A large number of people, including those hailing from the Northeast and locals, witnessed the colourful extravaganza. The event was organised by the government of Meghalaya and sponsored by the Northeastern Council with an aim to bridge the gap between the people of the Northeastern states and the rest of India. The event not only showcased the culture and traditions of the region, but also created awareness about the region, its prospects and potentials.
We need to feel proud of our artists of our culture. And what we have done is that we have exposed them and provided them a platform in such a place like Delhi, which they'll never dream of and they'll never get. Now, the youth who are staying here also, studying as well as working, and our people in general from the Northeast are very proud of such type of initiative, exposing them to the rest of the country. And that's what we are looking for. We want to tell the rest of the country, yes, we are Indians and we are proud of being Indians.
This is really nice to get together as, to unite as one. And I really appreciate for the people who organize this, and I really thank you for to Meghalaya government also to support us in this very event. And yeah, this is one of the very best thing, you know, I have experienced. Lots of people come up and get together, you know, introduce each other, and this is very good for the people like us from the Northeast people.
The major attraction at the venue was a food zone where people of the region put up their traditional food stalls. Many locals and foreigners got a chance to enjoy some delicious food prepared by them.
I'm very fond of Northeastern food, so I was here to really enjoy the Northeastern food. I've been to almost all the stalls here, tried something or the other. I've tried prawn from one, I've tried fish from other, I've yet to try the momos, but I've gone through all the stalls mostly.
We are participating in this event, and so far it's going very well. It's a good response, you know, not only from the Northeast, but as also, you know, the local people from here, and also the foreigners coming and trying the food. So it's a good response.
Altogether, 26 music bands from across the region enthralled the audience. Performances of Lost and Found from Manipur, Girish and the Chronicles from Sikkim, Soulmate from Meghalaya, Frisky Pines from Mizoram, Alobo and the Naga Band from Nagaland entertained the audience with their electrifying performances. Later, Borkum Krangpa, a rapper from Tripura, and DJ Ina from Nagaland also mesmerized the audience. Apart from the rock and blues, Koloma and the folk fusion band from Tripura and Folk Brothers from Sikkim also entertained the crowd. The musicians sent out a message of love, peace and unity through their songs.
Yeah, it's very, very good for the rising artists, actually, because you get a chance to showcase your talent and your music, and which is very hard out there, you know. So Delhi, Bangalore, all these places are the places to be for such.
It feels great to be a part of this event because I can see there are so many talented bands out here, and to be a part of them is a privilege on our part as well. So to be here, I'm really happy, and we are looking forward to perform on the stage.
We played Folk Fusion today, one song. It's been an honor coming here in Delhi for the second time, performing with our brothers and sisters from the Northeast in this song and dance of the Northeast Festival.
Be it bamboo dance from Mizoram, Wangala dance from Meghalaya, Pujagiri dance from Tripura, war dance from Arunachal, Bihu dance from Assam, Pung Shalom and stick dance from Manipur, Sangtam war dance from Nagaland, and snow lion dance from Sikkim. 126 artists from 8 states of Northeast came together to perform a cultural dance showcasing a perfect example of unity in diversity.
It was celebration time in Assam. Sounds of drum beats and cymbals were echoing all over the state as people celebrated their New Year or Rongali Bihu with tremendous enthusiasm. Take a look.
Hundreds of people gathered in Guwahati to celebrate Rongali Bihu, the most popular festival of Assam. Women clad in their traditional Bihu attires, along with men wearing their gamochas, swayed to folk tunes to welcome the new year. It is the time when farmers sow new seeds and offer prayers for a prosperous year ahead. Assam Chief Minister Tarun Gogoi and Sports Minister Sonowal also took part in the event.
আৰু খুব লক্ষণ যে অসমীয়া ভাষা কলা কৃষ্টি আজি সকলো শ্ৰেণীৰ মানুহক আমি আকৰ্ষণ কৰিব পাৰিছো আৰু এই বিহুটো কেৱল আমাৰ মাজতে আবদ্ধ থকা নাই অসমত বাস কৰা সকলো শ্ৰেণীৰ মানুহ সকলো ধৰ্মৰ সকলো জনগোষ্ঠী সকলোৱে আজি বিহু আকোৱালি লৈছে
To mark the festival, various Bihu functions were held across the city, as a part of which Bihu dance competitions were organized to promote the culture among the younger generation. The first day of Rongali Bihu is known as Goru Bihu. During the festival, farmers wash, feed and worship their bulls and cows as a sign of respect and gratitude for the service provided by the cattle. In Jorhat, a program was organized by the Assam Jatiyadabadi Yuva Chhatra Parishad at Meetha Pukri, where a group of dancers performed Bihu dance. Various communities like Boro, Missing, Tiwa also participated in the event. The festival is a time for merrymaking for the people and it also brings hope of peace and prosperity for the region.
We are all happy, we all celebrate this with lots of joy, lots of fun. And I hope this Bihu, along with the beginning of the Assamese New Year, the coming days will be full of lots of happiness. We hope the coming year in the Assamese calendar will be a peaceful one, a prosperous one for all the people of Assam and all the people of the world.
Amar hokolu nijor bhatritobbo rakhi ei bihur darai jan hokolu tyag kori dekhot hokor priti najoriye band khai rakok ei ami hokoluke akha janais so hokoluke ami antori khubeshcha janaisu.
The festival is celebrated thrice a year in the form of Rongali, Kathi and Magh Bihu. Such festivals play an important role of bringing together people and spreading the message of peace and harmony.
With that, we have come to the end of this episode of Roving Report. Do connect with us through our Facebook page and follow us on Twitter at @anyindia_ANI. You can also subscribe to our YouTube channel to get latest news updates from the Northeast. I'm your host Lumpim, signing off. Goodbye and take care.